Joining me right now is Texas Congressman, member of the House Ways and Means Committee, Jodey Arrington. Congressman, it's good to see you. Thanks very much for being here. You were part of the committee's markup yesterday.
Texas,
what can you tell us? What can you tell us in terms of the markup yesterday?
Well, I can tell you that the onslaught of the largest expansion of government and that radical reimagination of government's role in our life has ensued. Now, whether they can successfully get it across the finish line or not, that's still to be determined. But the fact that you have Democrats breaking rank so early in the process, which is very rare, and it's not just Stephanie Murphy from Florida based on process, there are substantive issues that and exceptions that Democrats have taken, like Ron Kine from Wisconsin, on the mandate for small businesses to expand benefits for employees, or they must be fined by their federal government. So we're seeing some fissures here that could cause problems down the road for sure.
Yeah, what about the menu of offsets that we're talking about? I know that, you know, the Democrats certainly are pushing to ensure that there are ways to pay for this, some Democrats anyway, like Joe Manchin. But I want to get your take on what the discussion is surrounding the tax increases and how to pay for it, because I know that Senator Wyden's plans include things like an excise tax on companies that have large stock buyback plans or an excise tax on companies that have high salaries for their CEOs. There's also talk of much higher taxes for wealth and investment, like a capital gains tax going all the way up to 43.4%. Are these realistic plans?
I don't think they're going to realistically accomplish all of the litany of taxes they want to levy on the American people, most of which will be borne by our small businesses and by working class folks. But they're going to raise our business tax rates higher than communist China, and that's at least in their plans. They have plans, Senator Wyden does, to repeal the 20% tax deduction that small businesses get. 21 million small businesses receive $66 billion in a tax break to incentivize growth and job creation. That's on the chopping block. And then you've got the very hostile and sinister death tax that would be the death of family farming. And you also have an assault, all-out assault, on fossil fuels. That's just mentioning a few. And again, this will make America less competitive. It will make it impossible for us to recover. By the way, this is on top of the tax on every man, which is the inflationary effects from the massive spending that we've seen to date. So again, the politics of this make it very difficult with a 3-seat margin in the House and only 1 seat to thread the needle in the Senate.
Yeah, I want to bring in one of my panelists here, but before we go there, let me get your take on foreign policy right now. Because last night we learned that President Biden had a call with Xi Jinping, the head of communist China. They gave us a readout of the president's call with Xi Jinping, and there's absolutely no details whatsoever in this readout about what they discussed and whether or not the president brought up the origins of the coronavirus. Then, of course, you've got the debacle in Afghanistan. What are your thoughts on China and the U.S. and this call with Joe Biden last night?
Well, I have no confidence in our chief executive and our commander-in-chief. I suspect most Americans don't in terms of presenting a strong front for our country, putting America first and not ceding to the likes of China. By the way, we saw this unilateral surrender and retreat because of his botched withdrawal in Afghanistan. But all that we've talked about with this big tax and spend is a unilateral economic surrender to China. And we've certainly done nothing to hold them accountable for the origins of COVID. We joined the World Health Organization without even a legitimate investigation of their being complicit with China. So, no, very little confidence that this president is going to do those things that need to be done to be strong and tough with China. And he's done nothing to enforce our trade agreement that Trump negotiated, where they made the largest purchase of American products in the history of our 30-year relationship. So I think that thing is going to dissipate as well, and they're going to probably reset to their stealing and cheating and taking advantage of the American economy and our generous trade relationship with them, unfortunately.
Well, that's exactly what they've been doing, and it's clear, Congressman, that we are a lot less safe today than 7 months ago when Joe Biden walked into the Oval Office. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin told a group of reporters yesterday that al-Qaeda could resurge in Afghanistan. He said, quote, the whole community is kind of watching to see what happens. So now we're just watching to see what happens. And by the way, you mentioned the World Health Organization. The director of the WHO, Tedros, is up for re-election. Okay, so this is the guy who repeatedly endorsed the Chinese Communist Party's slow and secretive response to COVID-19, helping China and the CCP conceal the origins of the outbreak. Tedros is up for re-election. We haven't heard a peep out of the White House on this. Do you think that Biden is going to put somebody in there that we are going to actually be able to trust?
Absolutely not. And if he was going to have any leverage to oust Tedros, he would not have rejoined the World Health Organization. We're paying, $120 million to join this organization that, again, was complicit with China. China is the real threat, and they pay half the rate to be part of this World Health Organization, which is that has done nothing to serve America's interests, for sure. And by the way, Secretary Austin needs to tell us something that we don't know, and he needs to be held accountable, along with other cabinet heads and generals. Everybody that was involved in the botched evacuation and withdrawal needs to be held accountable for either not giving the president the right advice or not standing up to the president and for his incompetence and putting the lives of our troops at risk. That's going to be forthcoming for sure.
Yeah, well, there's absolutely no accountability. This is Obama's national security team in place, begging to get back into the Iran deal, botching up the Afghanistan withdrawal, shutting down Bagram Air Base, which was incredibly strategically located for the United States. Congressman, we're going to keep a spotlight on it, and we'll have you back soon to talk about it. Thanks very much, sir. We appreciate your time today, Congressman Jodey Arrington.